that his joy was raven black, and it ran like a river of silk down her back. And she brushed it every morning 100 times, and he washed it for on Saturday nights. Then a drought struck the heartland in 1935, and they didn't have water for Saturday nights. It all seemed so hopeless, so she cut it with the shears, and he held her close and said through her tears, "I'll build you a barrel to catch the rain, wash out the dust of the Kansas plain. I swear you'll never have to cut your hair again. If it's the last thing I do on this earthly plane, I'll give you a barrel of rain." So he worked in the evenings when he finished up the chores, and cut out some staves from a chest of drawers. Then he bound them with leather and sealed them with tar. Then he got to his knees and prayed in the yard, "I've built this barrel to catch the rain, wash out the dust of the Kansas plain. You give me this, Lord, I'll never ask nothing again. Just a little thundercloud now and then to give her a barrel of rain." Barrel sat dry, and she watched as the truth of it ate him alive. Then God took the crops, and the bank took back the land. And when his spirit broke, he just folded his hand. And as the sun beat down on his thirsty grave, she thought of the fields that he plowed in vain. Then she screamed at the sky in all her rage and pain. Oh, he didn't want much and he never complained. Dear God, he just wanted a barrel of rain. His joy is now white as milk, and it runs down her back like a river of silk. And all that she brought to these Oregon shores was a barrel made out of an old chest of drawers. And the neighbors all whisper that she's insane, the way that she stares at the driving rain and waits for the gutters to fill it up again. Then on Saturday nights, if the sky is tame, she washes her hair in a barrel of rain.